In the middle of Savage Skulls and on the top of the hill with the Seven Crowns, the gangs were in the Bronx, and they were seriously getting down. It was little Vietnam, where even the police watched out for raids, and where the baddest of them all was a street gang known as the Black Spades. And from them emerged a boy who became the adopted father of the hip-hop generation, a Zulu, Afrika Bambaataa.
I got into street gangs, the Black Spades, a lot of other groups I was in before I became a Spade, Power, Bronx, Savage Nomads. And but Spades was one of the groups that I really loved a lot. It was a lot of unity in the group. It was one of the most hated groups in the whole city because all it was about was trouble and stuff and static. But it was one of the most organized black youth groups. As for if you mess with them, they would mess with you. And plus, in that year, 1975, one of the brothers that was close to me that lived with me for about 2 years, by the name of Solsky, got shot by the police on Pelham Bay along with some other members of the Spades. And he died, and this other member died, and one survived.
The violent death of Bam's best friend marked for him the end of the line. And he went back to a vision that once had occurred inside of his youthful mind. A way to fight, yet maintain peace. An impossible situation. Unless you could create something powerful, like his memory of the Zulu Nation.
Violence is necessary. Violence is a part of America's culture. It is as American as scary pie. Americans taught the black people to be violent. We will use that violence to rid ourselves of it.
Former slaves and the sons of former slave owners, will they be able to sit down together at the table of brotherhood? I have a dream. One day.
Basically, our ultimate goal in the Klan is to bring about a unification of all of the Anglo-Saxon and Protestant American citizens into a bond of unity to counteract the philosophies of the minority. And
there are many people who feel that it is useless and futile for us to continue talking peace and nonviolence against a government whose reply is only savage attacks on an unarmed and defenseless people.
We are not human beings unless we ourselves band together and do whatever, however, whenever is necessary to see that our lives and our property is protected. And I doubt that any person in here would refuse to do the same thing were he in the same position. Or I should say, were he in the same condition.
It was with the vision of the Zulu Nation, a trip to Africa and a death situation that produced a man who put on Zulu dress and began to transform a violent mess.
No sellout. No sellout. No sellout.
Bambaataa was always a music man, a record collector who, as a DJ, jammed. Now he saw a new idea to use Stand and Proud in his career, to put the Bronx in a music trance and move from violence to Zulu dance. And so it became hip to hop in the land known as Planet Rock, where gangs used to fight in the street every day. Now they began to compete in a different way. As the DJ's music made the house shake, the dancers would begin to break. Some electric boogie to move like toys, others would spin and became B-boys. The Breakers know what they have got. From electro boogie to street robot, they dance out the anger in a street or room. Who needs a gang when the beat goes boom?
Yes, can I help you? Yes. What are you doing around here?
You guys need to go back.
No.
I'm going to take all of you.
No.
Oh,
you want to take us out?
All right. Yeah. Let's go.
Money green. The system is mean, destroying all dreams. Flying to the moon, nobody's in the schools. Dude.